Coming up, we'll see the debut of Julio Jones as a Titan. But Tennessee hosts a dangerous Cardinals offense that can take flight at any time. Find out who has the better aerial attack next.
We welcome all of you to Nissan Stadium on the banks of the Cumberland River in downtown Nashville, Tennessee. The whole of downtown Nashville likely still reverberating with the sounds of the Titans taking the field a moment ago. They're ready for football as their Titans are set to match up with the Arizona Cardinals. Hello again, everyone. Brandon Gordon. So, and he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. CD, you take a look at this draft class from this offense, and they went defense with their first-round pick.
Yeah, and you and I both know there were a lot of good players on that list, but this was a defense that was in need of an infusion of youth and speed, and that's what they got.
A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Now Murray. And they will touch him down, but not before he gets the first. And a nice start there to the aerial attack to pick up the first.
And I think preseason is officially over now. Getting into the groove of the regular season, that's a great way to get started. First drive of the season, what a nice completion.
Now a handoff as they run left side. Nowhere to go that time. He maybe got a yard up to the 40.
No doubt about it. Really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
Extra defensive back out there for the Titans now here for third down. Here's Murray. Into a double team and it's intercepted.
Picked off by the rookie from Virginia Tech, Caleb Farley.
Come on, Titans.
Now come the Titans for it.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And he'll be out right at the 35. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out by a few inches. That'll be a first down. A perfect example right there, Charles, of why they love this rookie runner.
And think about how the NFL and the college games are meshing together more and more. You don't have to go to the NFL and learn a new set of skills. What you did in college often makes you ready for the NFL.
Give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later. And let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's up over midfield and down into Tennessee territory. A gain of 3, second down. And to give this time to the tailback. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. Cardinal football here to start quarter number 2. After 1, 7-0, EA Sports. And he'll give it here to his running back. Room here to run. Touchdown, Cardinals. A great play there. with his first career touchdown in his first career game. And the Cardinals are just an extra point away from tying this game.
And that one heck of a run right there. Once he got loose, you could tell that he was going to run a long way. That was pretty impressive.
And there's an old chestnut of an expression called get.
Now a handoff here to his running back. Only a couple there as he'll be brought down about the 28. So CD, big changes for 2021. Of course, last year we had the expansion from 6 to 7 teams in each conference making the playoffs. This year to headline the addition of a 17th regular season game. What did you think when you heard the news that this was happening?
Well, my first thought, partner, was finally, because we've heard about a 17th game coming for a long time, and now here it is. So the beautiful part about all of it is that 17th game is going to be like these interdivision, interconference type games that are going to match up and play out over a four-year period, and that's kind of cool. And I was looking forward to seeing some of the matchups that were going to come out of that for that 17th game. And could that be the game that decides a bunch of division titles?
And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so. On fourth down, here's Brett Kern to punt the football away. It's a 39-yard punt, and good coverage means a loss on the return. And the Cards are going to have the football with a first and 10 deep in their own territory. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get.
And he's taken down. Back in his own 7. The sack by Harold Landry, the former Boston College Eagle. And that one going to be off target and incomplete.
Well, as we get ready for third down, let's go back and recap here. The sack on the first play of this drive, that threw a wrench in what they were trying to accomplish because they were compelled to throw the ball on second down. A running play was not in the works. And that incompletion set up another passing down here on third and long.
And he's going to have a first down, and they get into field goal range here at the 29.
A good pickup there, a 22.
Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete. Here's second and 10.
To throw is Murray. Forced out to his left. Murray has the first down and more. And this turns into a nice gain with a slide at the end. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. A pair of first downs gives them a first and 10 up at the 44. Murray gonna throw. Going deep for Hopkins. All right, rifles one, and that's gonna be intercepted. Picked by Kevin Byard. And his guys have got it. Here's Brett Kern now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. No returning this one. It sails out of bounds, and they'll spot it right at the 20. The Cardinals offense now ready to get their first opportunity here in the second half.
And their defense did its job by forcing the punt to start things out. And now, Charles, can the offense get in gear?
I think, partner, you can sense them saying, okay, the first half was theirs, but now let's get the momentum back on our side. We forced a punt. Now let's go downfield and score. If we do that, we'll be set up well for the second half.
Now a throw downfield is taken in by his running back. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains. And to give this time to the tailback. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards. A good run, got 7 on first. Here's 2nd and 3. And he'll give it here to his running back. They find some open field here. Touchdown, Cardinals. A big play there. Making quite a splash with his second touchdown of his NFL debut. As his guys have now moved out in front. So there, Charles, I mean, a situation where it didn't matter how far he had to run, he was not going to be denied, and he winds up taking this all the way to the end zone.
And that's his second touchdown run of this game, and this one add a high degree of difficulty to it as well.
Now a handoff here to his running back. He'll get about three as he's brought down right around at 42.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook.
Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he's gonna be stopped up at about the 47-yard line. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 165 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. We are through three quarters here on NFL Kickoff Weekend. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA. Oh, no, he lost the football. It's picked up by the Titans. And now off to the races, down the right side. And they're going to bring this one back. A fumble return. This time to the tailback. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to draw that. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. Now a handoff here to his running back. This a big play for both sides. What will we see here? Third and four. And to give this time to the tailback. And he will not get there as they stop him short right around the 34-yard line. It's a pickup of three, and we have now arrived. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. We've got a one-score game with inside. So the Cardinals, they've got the football here as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. Oh, he finds his running back who snuck right down the middle of the field. And he'll have it past mid. Now Murray's got to have this one. He's going to have his running back. It's complete. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line.
I'm the devil, got you piping hot. This up and you get straight chopped on Michael Watts. When I was young, I knew I should have been a rap a lot. Think like Jay Prince and I do more than just rap a lot. I went and got my digits up. Your favorite, bruh.
Up next, we'll see Kyler Murray staring down a man he's faced many a time in practice. Patrick Peterson returns to the place he called home for 10 seasons. It's the Vikings and Cardinals, and it's next.
We find ourselves at the home of the world's first retractable natural grass field as you get a look inside State Farm Stadium in Glendale. It's certainly hot outside here in the desert, but somehow this Cardinal crowd turned up the heat a moment ago. They were in a frenzy as their team emerged from the tunnel, and the Cardinals, they're set to do battle with the Minnesota Vikings. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Charles, you look at this Cardinal team as they get ready here. They come in off a loss in the opener last week. That one was on the road. Now they get their first taste here of home cooking.
And what they're hoping to do is feed off the energy of the home crowd. Great tailgate, great fan support. Let's see if they can put it to good use.
Meanwhile, for our visitors, the Vikings, they come into this one after a loss in the opener, and they're in for another tough test here.
And what about...
down as he gets this one up to the 34-yard line. In a word, I would say productive, finding the end zone three different times.
Is it possible that you're really underselling it? Three touchdowns, you're just going to call him productive?
Right. Yeah. What do you want?
This guy had a nose for the end
zone. He was good.
Had a snoopful, didn't he? How about that? Big-time game.
But just play number three here on the opening drive, and it's an early third and one. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And this is going to be a Cardinals first down as the tackle made just shy of the 40. Another good run there for a guy who, remember, on Wednesday was named NFC Offensive Player of the Week for what he did a week ago.
Yeah, and you know it takes some solid runs and some extra special ones in order to win that type of an award. I think he's locked in and wants to get it done a second time.
He's got the first down and more past midfield. And down to the 19-yard line. 56 yards rushing for him as he's got the afternoon off to a great start. Well, I tell you what, when you get a running back who can move like that in the open field, that's something to take advantage of, and they certainly did there.
And first and foremost, this is all about vision. He can see the play developing right in front of him, and once he's past the line of scrimmage and got a full head of steam behind him, he's just going to keep right on going.
And his maximum speed there, according to the next-gen stats, 21.9 miles per hour. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. And he'll give it here to his running back. He'll get forward for three down to the 16-yard line. But Charles, we get a look there at the draft class for this offense. What do you make of it?
Well, overall, I like the balance of the guys that they selected because, to me, they got a few guys who can step in and play right away, which is exactly what you want. But they also drafted for the future as well. They got some guys who might need a year or two on the practice squad, so then we'll find out if they can actually play.
He's got his man. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. So on fourth down, Britton Colquitt on the punt. And last week in the loss, five punts as he gets this one away. This will be fielded at the 17. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And the Cards will take over, first and 10. Arizona's offense at the line, ready to get their drive started. And certainly they'll be hoping to hit pay dirt like they did on the last drive. Got the football back, so a chance to go up two scores.
And they haven't been tentative at all in this ball game, because sometimes you start a game with your script to try and get information out of the opposing defense. How will they play you in certain situations? Sometimes you script to attack, and that's what I'm seeing so far.
And he'll have this pass the 30, prior to going out of bounds. A gain of 10, first down, Arizona. One thing's for sure, this defense has to figure out how to stop the ground game. He's eating him up here in the first quarter.
It looks like they have to go to different forces, aren't they? The conventional things aren't working too well. So I remember a coach of mine saying way back when, but a back's having a great game, you've got to get the ball out of his hands. See how far he can run without the ball. And what he meant was takeaways, not get loose, because maybe you can't just stop him with just regular tackling.
Now a handoff here to his running back. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three. And to give this time to the tailback. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. He was well over 100 yards last week. He told us this week, a little ambitious, said he wants to hit that 200 mark. We'll see.
Makes sense, though, doesn't it? Have we ever run into a running back that had a great game the week before that didn't think that's just going to naturally continue, just make sure you feed me the football? And that's what they're all about. Continuity, rhythm, number of carries, just keep giving it to him.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. 9 yards on the play there, and it'll set him up first and goal. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. A great play there with his second touchdown. Here's Britton Colquitt now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And a fair catch taken here right at about the 40-yard line. Just 34 yards on the punt there, no return. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And to give this time to the tailback. And he's got room. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. 164 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here in this first half. Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And he'll get a little over 2, maybe a full 3 down to the 32-yard line. The last run got a couple. Here's 2nd and 8. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped.
I'm not sure how much more evidence they need, partner, than to understand that if they don't start to slow him down, it's going to be a long afternoon here at the stadium, because he is just shredding them at this point. And let's face it, coming into the game, they knew he would be the focal point of their attack. This is going to take an 11-man unit on the defensive side to start making plays.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. A great effort there. On his way to a monster game. 3 first half touchdowns. Here's Britton Colquitt now as he's on to punt for Minnesota. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken just outside. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. Leading 14 back, but it leads now to a third down. And to give this time to the tailback. And he's got some space here. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays. Well, he's broken off some big-time runs here in this first half.
Yeah, and let's just face it. When you go into a game, you think you've got the plays that are going to work, but when you actually get out there and they're starting to happen, your confidence rises.
There he goes, right side. Touchdown, Cardinals. Kyler Murray, 54 yards.
guy with an awful lot of things going for him, we know that. But at this stage, might be tough to decide whether he's a better passer or runner. And that was a heck of a run there.
And this is a play defensively where you're just looking around and saying, what was that? What just happened? You're looking at your teammates, they're looking.
Here's Britton Colquitt now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. Fair catch taken just inside the 40-yard line. It'll wind up just a 35-yard punt, no return. And that will come the offense as they take over. Arizona's offense at the line, ready to get their drive started. They'll start by running the option to the right. And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
And that's what I'd like to see out of this defense, a little fire, a little toughness. It hasn't been the best first half for them, but they did do a nice job there, forcing a loss on that play.
Now he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down. Now the Cards going to call another timeout, their second, as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's got enough for the first across midfield to the 48. So we've come to half. Due to time constraints, we move you forward in today's broadcast to the beginning of the third quarter.
Welcome back, everybody, to State Farm Stadium in Glendale, Arizona. We're in the second quarter, and it's the Cardinals in control of the football. And now Murray's going to set up to throw. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Mackenzie Alexander with a pick. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. Here's Britton Colquitt now, as he's on for the fifth time here today. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. It'll be a net of 40 yards there following a 43-yard punt, 3-yard return, and the Cards will take over first and 10.
The Cardinals offense now ready to get their first opportunity here in the second half. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down. Now a handoff here to his running back, and they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down. Going to give this time to the tailback. They're going to snuff this play out behind the line. We have not seen that much today. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. They'll roll him out right. And he'll slide to a halt here, still a little shy of the first down marker. Give him 7 there on the tuck and run, and they're in better shape now for third. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he will lose yardage back to the 30. The Vikings send out their punter. And no room for error here as his first punt comes from deep in his own end zone. Now here's a timeout defensively coming from the Cardinals. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. And he'll just punch it out of there, and it's not a great kick. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. 37 yards on the punt with no return. And the Cardinals' great field position to start this drive as they take over first and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And they'll get this just to the 47. 1 yard gain. Here's 2nd and 9, just 1 yard on that last run. And again, this time to the tailback. Despite the strong run, he'll be hit and dropped shy of the 45.
When we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get you.
Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Anthony. They fake the handoff. Now Murray. This one caught by Max Williams. And this one down near the 20-yard line. Just shy of the 20. A good pick up there. 26 yards. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. It's a good gain of 11, sets him up first and goal.
No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point in the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey.
And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. A 3-yard touchdown run. And the they'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down. Now a handoff here to his running back. And good penetration here. He'll get this down only to about the 49. taken in at the 22. They call that a punt of 38 yards officially. And out will come the offense as they take over. Getting set to go again as we look at the back, heading onto the field again. Man, those numbers from last week. What do you call a game like that? Monumental? A career game?
Yeah, every one of those adjectives you can pull up. Monumental, mammoth, massive. But you also know that he wants another one just like it in this game. He doesn't plan on slowing down.
Man, if he duplicates that would be history. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. And he'll give it here to his running back. He's got the first down and more past midfield. And he's got it across the 50 to the 47-yard line. Give him 16 yards there, and it's a Cardinals first down as well. Now a handoff here to his running back. He takes it down to the 42, a 5-yard run. He was locked in last week, NFC Offensive Player of the Week in Week 2.
Throw some space in the trophy room. He won it last week. He's thinking he's going to get a few more before this season is over, maybe even starting with this game.
And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, this shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down. Otherwise, it's going to be a long afternoon.
2 yards the loss, second and 12. Play fake, Murray. Catch made there by Travis. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars' 15-yard line.
But normally you see three tight ends in a formation, you have to think to yourself, this has got to be a run, and I know as a safety, when I saw that, I took an extra step or two towards the line of scrimmage. Instead, they threw the ball, and he found one of those tight ends for a very nice pickup.
Going to give this time to the tailback. And effective running here. He'll take it down inside the 10. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
This guy's well on his way now to a big game on the ground. It's another good run there. Puts him over the century mark in yardage, and we're still in the second quarter.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. 4 yards on the play. That's going to lead to 1st and goal.
They were not fooling around at all, were they? 2nd and short, and they brought out the heavy package. Almost like the super heavy package against that defense, didn't it?
Yeah, I don't think they expected that much beef up front, and it turned into an easy first down conversion. They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And the D not yielding much there. He's only going to get a yard to about the 2. Good first step there defensively, but they're still knocking on the doorstep. So maybe another run here?
I think so. One of my favorite coaches just say, son, if you could darn near lay down near the end zone and get in, give me my best power running play with my best back right now.
From the 2 now, 2nd and goal. They'll try to run this one in. And he is in for 6. Touchdown, Cardinals. A great play there with touchdown. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. 2nd and right at a yard. The previous run, good for 9. Here's 2nd and a yard. And to give this time to the tailback. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line.
2nd and 1 is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
3 tight ends in the ball game here on 1st and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 130 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this first half. Now a handoff here to his running back. Miles Jack there to make the tackle.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down. Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he'll get it down inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. And he'll give it here to his running back. Stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of 5. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. Now a handoff here to his running back, and he will have a first down at about the 21-yard line. Now the Cards going to call another timeout, their 2nd, as the stoppage will come with 23 seconds to go till halftime. Now Murray off play action. And he's got his big tight end over the middle, complete. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call.
Love the play call that time. Love the design.
They'll start the 3rd quarter here on the ground. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards. He had a really solid first half running the football and picking up where he left off here in the 3rd quarter.
How about the yardage he's piling up right now? This feels like a full game, not just the series that we're watching right now. I know people are screaming, where are the adjustments from halftime on the defensive side of the ball? Sometimes they're just not there. Sometimes you just have to find a way to tackle someone.
Excellent job pushing through tacklers that time to pick up 6. 6 yards on that last play. Here's 2nd and 4. Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And he's going to take this across midfield into Jacksonville territory. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. 12 yards the pickup. Good enough for an Arizona first. Now a handoff here to his running back. Powering his way forward. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first. And to give this time to the tailback. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9. And quickly, they get to the line. And he'll give it here to his running back. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. An important play right here, 3rd and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll only get this to the 17, well shy of what he... And the Jaguars send out their punter as he's on to kick it away. And a fair catch called for and made at the 12-yard line. It'll wind up just a 35-yard punt, no return. And the Cards are going to have the football with a 1st and 10 deep in their own territory. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? I mean, they score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly because What you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, in fact, you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
Right back to him on first down. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 15 more yards there, and quickly another first down. So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 37-yard line. And he'll take this one down to the 36. We have played three quarters. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. The last run good for two. Here's second and 8. And to give this time to the tailback. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first. From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. The broken tackle could not free him as he's brought down at the 10-yard line. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. Now a handoff here to his running back. And from the 9, they get this to the 5-yard line.
Well, sometimes it's hard to take your eyes off this guy at the linebacker position. He can really cover some ground, and he did there to make that.
He's got his man. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Ross Travis, his first touchdown of the new season. And the Cardinals are looking to make it 2 straight as they add on to this 4th-quarter lead. I've heard you use the term put-away drive, and that right there seemed like the definition of a put-away drive.
Yeah, it certainly just pops right up out of the book, doesn't it? Because up 2 scores already, just wanted to possess the football, keep converting and picking up first downs, and if the drive ends in 3 points, that's terrific. If it ends in a touchdown, fantastic.
It appears they're going to throw forward with Murray. And this is going to be caught. So add 2 more to the lead as they continue to pour it on here in the 4th. So they elect to pass there on the 2-point. There it worked out. And the Jaguars send out their punter as the drive goes backwards. So he's on to punt it away. Just a net of 34 there, following a punt of 44 yards. And possession will switch hands, 1st and 10. Here's the Arizona offense now as they get set to take over. With this lead and the football, things obviously looking good, but maybe, you know, you've taught me this before, maybe this is where the defense is hoping that the offense helps them preserve that shutout that they've got going.
And it has to be in the minds of the offense that they know how rare it is to get a shutout. So take care of them, protect them, take care of the ball, move it downfield, run the clock down. You don't want your defense to have to go on the field again the rest of the game. Reward them.
And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. The Cardinals on 3rd down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This will be 3rd and 5. Now they'll run the option to the short side left. And to the 49-yard line, but no further. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. To the 40 and no further, so the razzle-dazzle didn't get him much. Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8. Gonna give this time to the tailback. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. A yard in the wrong direction makes 3rd down tougher. 3rd down and 9. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. It's a gain of 11 and a Cardinal first down.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
And he'll give it here to his running back. Room to run inside the 40. And he'll be taken down at the 26. 25 yards the pickup there, and also a first down.
It carries like that. That's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
So it's a win here.
It's week four, and in the NFC West, we've got the first division matchup for the Cardinals and the Rams. Arizona's lost 8 straight games to LA and look to end the streak next.
So on fourth down, here's Johnny Hecker to punt it away. They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. Call it 46 yards on the punt, just a single yard on the return as he was covered quickly. Arizona Cardinals offense coming out here for the first time, and you get a peek at Kyler Murray, a dangerous offensive weapon now in his third season in the National Football League.
I like this guy, and the reason I do, he tends to stay on an even keel, doesn't let too much ruffle him. He will manage the game the way it needs to be managed, take what the defense gives him, and then he can strike at times. Had a touchdown pass. Yes, he had an interception last week, but he found a way for his team to win.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. Now a handoff here to his running back. Stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of 5. Another good run there for a guy who, remember, on Wednesday was named NFC Offensive Player of the Week for what he did a week ago.
Yeah, and you know it takes some solid runs and some extra special ones in order to win that type of an award. I think he's locked in and wants to get it done a second time.
And he is going to have a Cardinals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. And after his performance last week, everybody saw it. Unbelievable. You can expect a heavy dose of him again, I think.
Without a doubt. I mean, why wouldn't you? Because once you establish yourself that way, it's not just him, okay? It's his offensive line, it's the tight end, it's your wide receivers, everyone now sharing in the load and sharing in the belief that if they do their job, they'll see another performance just like they saw the week before.
And 3 yards there takes him to the 45.
Heavy set out there on third and one. This defense for the Rams, they were terrific a week ago in that victory over Tampa Bay, Charles.
It's a little bit enlightening talking with the defense coordinator about their performance last week, because the feeling was that it was a good, solid performance. They did what they needed to do to get the job done and get the win, but definitely a few lapses that they're looking to correct.
Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. 41 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries.
That's a very nice game there. A confidence-building run. Love the execution up front. And the way he pressed the hole, absolutely perfect.
So from Rams territory now, it's 1st and 10 at the 43. And he'll give it here to his running back. Trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and no more. Officially no gain on the play, and it's 2nd down. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for 3rd down. Now a handoff here to his running back, and he's able to get it to the 31, and that's enough for the first. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs. All runs on this drive so far. It's 1st and 10. Gonna give this time to the tailback. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. No gain on the play. It'll be 2nd down. And he'll be taken down, as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. We're scoreless after one. Cardinal football here to start quarter number two, as they've got it with a 1st and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. A great effort there. With touchdown number 8 on the year, as his guys are first out of the scoreboard here this afternoon. A solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown. Here's Johnny Hacker now, as he'll punt it away for the 2nd time. And they'll play keep away from the returner, as this one will be marked out of bounds at the 13-yard line. Pretty good spot. There again is the running back as he trots onto the field. He's in his own 2nd quarter, already closing in on a 100-yard game.
And that's the magic number for a running back. Anytime you get to that triple digits, that's all you're looking for. But he's got a chance to really exceed that in this one.
Yeah, he does. That's been the gold standard for a long time, hasn't it, that 100-yard mark?
It really has, and that never has to shift because it's in a game. It's a 1,000-yard mark. I'm wondering, since we've gone from 12 to 14 to 16 games, maybe we need to up that a little.
Good yardage as he rumbles for 24 and a first. Running game working, they'll stick with it on 1st down. And this winds up a pickup of 2, maybe 2.5, to about the 39.
They went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Yeah, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, maybe he was a little tired. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a 2nd back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A Cardinal 1st down on a gain of 13. Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he's got this down to the 35. 13-yard gain yet again, just like last play.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And for one of the few times here today, this one's not going to go anywhere. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd down. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. 2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth, and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy.
159 yards rushing for him here as he starts to draw closer to a 1,000-yard campaign. Now a handoff here to his running back. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6.
Well, if you're going to have a relay race, you're probably going to pick your backs and receivers to run it. But don't underestimate the conditioning of the offensive line. They're out there just dictating things, staying on the field, and keeping a long drive going.
Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. And to give this time to the tailback. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's 3rd down.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. What that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
The Rams go ahead and... Play action, it's Murray. And this turns into a nice game with a slide at the end. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number 1. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another 1st and 10. Williams brings it in. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. They'll start the 3rd quarter here on the ground. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. Call it a gain of 4 on 1st, and that'll make it 2nd down.
2nd and 6.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get it behind the line. Play action. Now it's Murray. That escapes the sack. But in the end, the pressure too great. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. It's been an excellent day for him running the football, no doubt, as he continues to soar well past 100 yards.
Yeah, it almost feels like he can just grab his briefcase and head home after putting in a full day's work at the office, doesn't it?
And a good pickup there. He gets about 6 up to midfield. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him, so when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
And to give this time to the tailback. And always going to be brought down by the face mask. Here come the flags. This is going to get him a 1st down. Well, I guess that's one way to slow him down, try to grab him by the face mask.
Well, nothing else seems to have worked because he certainly had his way running the football in this one.
And he'll give it here to his running back. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And some nice running going to get him down close to a first down at the Rams 24. Boy, 203 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
Set him back 5 yards. And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. Gonna give this time to the tailback. And they'll get this down to the 10. 3 quarters in the books. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Back now here on EA Sports. Knotted up here at 10. That's our score as we begin quarter number 4. We saw a number of good games earlier today. This one might top all of those. It's been a dandy as we come up on first and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. A great play there. His second touchdown of the game and his 9th on the year. And the Cardinals have taken the lead. So still touchdown. Here's Johnny Hacker now as he's on to punt for L.A. It's a 44-yard punt, just 3 on the return. And the Cards will take over, 1st and 10. A look at the running back, the man out of the backfield as he gears up to go again. And he's already gone over 200 yards on the ground as we get a look at some of his solid work.
And the guys I know, they think about 100 yards each and every game. That's the confidence factor. That's the level they think they should be getting to. Rarely do they admit to saying, I'm going to go for 200 or more in a game. That's what we're seeing right here. What a combination of great runs, vision, power, terrific blocking. It's all come together in this one.
And nearly impossible to stop. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he is met at the line of scrimmage. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he's going to be met at about the 43. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be 2nd down.
Again, 2. Brings up 2nd and 8. At the 43-yard line.
Accepted, of course, and that moves him back 5. Gonna give this time to the tailback. They'll get 4 on 2nd down, but it leaves him with 3rd and still 9 to go. Now the objective there, I mean, yes, the positive gain, that's nice, but work some clock.
Yeah, you're exactly right, but the problem for them is still within a possession, so they can't just sit on it running the ball. They'll have to find a way to throw it effectively as well.
Murray gonna throw. And Murray in trouble here, and down he goes. Leonard Floyd. And he'll give it here to his running back. No gain on the play there. Second down. Now Murray. Oh, he finds his running back who snuck right down the middle of the field. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as they get it with 26 seconds to go in the football game. To throw is Murray. And oh, that nearly their first. First down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Well, we were on hand for a fun and entertaining game here, coming down really to that last play. Great job defensively to get the pick and seal it.
And we know that every play during a game matters. You're never sure which one's going to be one of the key ones. But at the end of the game, when you analyze it, 3, 4, 5 plays are going to be the ones you focus on. And that last play was one of them. The last shot, had to take it, and they came up with the interception and sealed their victory.
So for the Cardinals, they're on a nice early roll as they...